Satnam, welcome to day 29 of the 40-day Ride Kundalini Yoga Challenge. Find yourself comfortably seated on your mat, on a chair, whatever your body is capable of today. Start to go within, breathe long and deep into the pelvic floor. Align yourself, become present in this moment. This is your time that you dedicate to you. Make sure that you have blocked out the time that you need for this practice. As you're breathing in, tuning into your body, ensuring that you are fully supported by the earth below you. Your legs are resting comfortably on the floor, or you're seated in a chair with your feet flat on the floor. Feel yourself rooted and grounded into the earth fully. Feel the ease and just being right here, right now. Elongating up through the spine from the base of the tailbone all the way up through the crown of the head, like someone is pulling a string and elongating you. Feel each vertebrae comfortably stacked one over the other. The ears are over the shoulders with the chest lifted just slightly as you open your heart and squeeze those shoulder blades in together. Shoulders can come up to the ears and roll down the back so that those ears are comfortably over the shoulders and the shoulders are comfortably over the hips. There's no need to hold in tension, but to. So as you find yourself here in calm and steady, breathing into those areas of discomfort, just keeping your eyes closed down, relaxing into this moment for you. What do you feel here? Feel the breath as it goes in through the nose, down the throat, lifting the chest, expanding the diaphragm and the belly, and then the belly. The chest lowers, the diaphragm flattens, and the belly pulls in at the navel center. Notice any areas that may be bothering you. Just really send them the love, this prana, this energy life force. Allow yourself to be filled up fully. Today, I just want to say hi. I hope you're having an amazing Friday. Friday is what I like to call it. We're going to do this aerobic capacity and efficiency Kriya. Now, the beauty here is it's actually going to oxygenate, and it's a one exercise Kriya, so it's very short, but it's very powerful and effective. I want to remind you, always have your water with you. If you have a journal to write in, that's extremely helpful and cathartic. Not only do we need the breath, but it's nice to also have the water. Both move in waves, right? Some visible and some not. If this is your first time tuning in, please spread a little love on the share button. Sharing is caring. You never know whose life you may touch. And these practices may change someone's life, and I hope they are helping and serving you. Also, make sure you have your notifications set to on and see first so that you don't miss any of these. So we're going to start with the tune in. We rub our hands together briskly, creating this energy that's more palatable the more we create the friction. You feel the heat, right? And those areas you may have felt tension, discomfort in, take those healing hands and place them there and breathe long and deep into those spaces. If this is your first time, we chant on one breath. We inhale to tune in with the Adi Mantra. It's Om Namo Gurudev Namo. The Om is meant to vibrate the cranial area. It's like a shell. And so when we go Om, you should feel this vibration throughout your skull and your forehead. And then it's Om Namo tuning into our body and setting an intention and feeling the prana soften and release anything that we may be holding on to. With each inhale, expand. On each exhale, release. Hands to heart center, thumbs in and up at the sternum, that nice little notch between the breastbones. Roll the shoulders up to the ears, let the shoulder blades glide down the back to lift that heart up. Let's breathe in together. Exhale, release. Inhale. Exhale, and now inhale to begin the Adi Mantra. Inhale. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Om. Exhale, release, bring the hands down to the knees. Just begin a nice Sufi grind. So inhale, pulling the chest forward. Exhale, around to the side, opening up the side body. And then rounding the back back and over to the other side as you inhale forward. And you want to keep your head level with the hips. This is a beautiful, it never hurts to do a Sufi grind. Inhaling forward, exhaling rounding the back. The side, feeling the opening. Really feel the juiciness, getting that spinal fluid moving, opening up the fascia, stretching it, getting fresh oxygen and blood to those areas in between each vertebrae. So this particular kriya, it's a massive impact on the body and the nervous system and the heart. It builds stamina, it increases the efficiency of the lungs and bringing oxygen into the blood. It pressurizes the heart to regulate it itself and adjust the various heart muscles so they cooperate with one another. It's also helpful for the kidneys and adrenals and the sex organs. You want to make sure you have your water because you may be thirsty at the very end of this. So. And just to share a couple things, inhale to center. Exhale the opposite direction. Feel the difference in going from one side to the other. Inhaling forward, exhaling around and rounding that back, really opening up each vertebrae. Each rib area in the rib cage. The increased aerobic vitality that results after doing this kriya for 40 days or more, it says that it will make your life richer and more positive, providing a reserve capacity to face challenges. Disease develops when the body gets less oxygen, so this is going to oxygenate your body more. It eliminates less waste when you are lacking in oxygen. So, and the brain and the organs and glands decrease their functioning and they suffer the most. So eventually, even though the system breaks down, this kriya helps to prevent that breakdown and maintain your vital capacity as you age. So these are key things. You know, we think, oh, we're aging. We're not breathing, we're not living fully. Inhale to center. We've cut off our life support, that prana. And so whether it's a matter of fight or flight, we can claim ourselves through these practices. So here we go, without further ado. We're gonna sit in easy seated position right here. We're gonna place our hands on our knees. Our arms will stay straight. We're going to have a light Jalahandha Bandha, which is the neck lock, so you'll feel the pressure along the sides of the throat. There is no actual focus of the eyes, so we close the eyes down and we focus at the third eye. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to sit very erect. You want your spine to be elongated, and you're going to stretch the rib cage to the maximum capacity, like you're being lifted. The arms, what we do is we use the arms to inhale, place the tongue at the roof of the mouth, at the foremost front of the top of the mouth behind the teeth. You're going to lock it there. When you inhale, you're going to suspend the breath, hold the breath, and on that inhale, you're going to flex the spine smoothly but fairly rapid. While holding the breath, you don't want to let any breath out. And then you're going to do this until you feel you can't hold the breath any longer. And then you're going to release the breath forcefully. You come back to center. You breathe back in, sitting up straight. Exhale forcefully when you have gone through that process. So, we're quickly inhaling and continuing the spinal flex while holding the tongue at the roof of the mouth. These are key things to remember. So as we come into the position, the neck lock stays. We're not bobbing the head and we don't want to hunch the shoulders. What we want to do is have a straight spine and we want to open the rib cage to the fullest of capacity. So we inhale, suspend the breath, stick the tongue, lock it at the roof of the mouth, at the forefront of the roof of the mouth behind the teeth. And we're going to continue this for a while. So again, listen to your body. It's a rapid, smooth move while holding the breath and the tongue at the roof of the mouth. The eyes are closed. And then when we come to the point where we can no longer hold the breath, we come to center and forcefully exhale it. So there's the instructions. If you have any questions, please place them in the comment section at any time. I always go back through the comments, okay? So get ready. And inhale and begin. one. Inhale, suspend the breath. Concentrate at the brow point. Exhale, relax. Go within. Notice what you're feeling. Allow the prana to circulate. As you're ready, hopefully you have your water handy, because I know it brought up thirst for me. And so, I hope you enjoyed those kriya. That was 11 minutes, which is what is written down in the book. But to master the kriya, it's recommended, and here's how you can obtain all the benefits. You have to build up your capacity to hold your breath for up to a minute while doing the spinal flex. And I know for myself, it still takes time. And some days it's easier, and some days it's harder. Don't let your mind tell you can't do something. Just try it and do the best you can. So it also says that while holding the breath for a minute on the spinal flexing, that you want to build the exercise up to 22 minutes. Since we did 11 minutes, you would do double. And it says that you can actually do it. The best way to do it would be to do 11 minutes and have a 3 to 5 minute break in between, and then do another 11 minutes. All right, so please let me know in the comments how you like this kriya. It's very good for opening up the lungs, obviously, if you haven't been. And if you feel a little lightheaded after this particular kriya, just go within and sit with this, because it's very powerful. And you're oxygenating areas that probably have been lacking or depleted, right? So we're bringing that life force back within to the body. So, without further ado, of course, we're going to close with the long time sunshine. So bring the hands to heart center. Inhale to begin. May the long time sun shine upon you. All love surround you. the long time sunshine upon you. All love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on, guide your way on, guide your way on. Inhale for one long set now. So when you do not consciously relate to your body, your mind does not relate consciously to you. Satnam. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Have an amazingly blessed day. Please reach out to me and let me know how these kriyas and these practices are serving you. I wish you the best. Lots of love. Be blessed.